Welcome to Raising Vibrations with myself, Simon. Today, guys, we're going to be going through the Neptune series and I'm going to be completing it. Today, we're going to be discussing Neptune through the eighth house or in Scorpio. Now, this is a really, really interesting and intense placement to have Neptune. I'm not going to lie, this is not something that I'm going to sugarcoat for you guys. The placement of Neptune in the eighth house can be incredibly painful when it comes to the nature of your reality. Hopefully throughout this video, I'll be able to share with you the nature of why Neptune in the eighth house is manifesting, but also at the same time, how to heal through this process as well, okay? As usual, before you go ahead and watch this video, make sure to check out the introduction video first. Obviously, there's information about the nature of Neptune there and how it actually functions within the birth chart and its symbolic representation or meaning, okay? So really important, and it is in the playlist anyway, so you can just check out the introduction of Neptune. Now guys, when we're looking at Neptune through the eighth house, we are combining the Neptunian field, which as you guys know, it's about the unification, it's about the nature of our illusions, it's about the nature of where we reject the ultimate meaning into our reality. In other words, where we see things that are above or beyond the state of consciousness of maybe other people with Neptune somewhere else. So we are seeing things that is unavailable to other people's eyes, wherever Neptune is. Now, with Neptune manifesting in Scorpio, we know that the nature of Scorpio in itself is inherently intense. We're looking at the nature of confrontations in our limitations, and we're understanding the nature of emotional security, unconscious emotional security. Essentially, what we are knowledgeable about that creates a sense of security within us, that we're knowing it. Yet at the same time, it also creates limitations within our psyche because obviously we're not expanding the nature of our consciousness. So when we're looking at Neptune through the eighth house, we're also examining the nature of what Scorpio symbolizes through the human condition. Now, because many of us form relationships with people and extend trust and commitment, Scorpio words, we also get stung with the experience of abandonment and betrayal and loss. And extreme amounts of this. Now, from the point of view of loss itself and abandonment, we can definitely internalize that because when we place our security outside of ourselves and the universe takes it away, you can see how this relationship is manifesting where we feel abandoned by God, we feel abandoned by things. And also at the same time, we feel abandoned by the nature of humanity and people itself. This person did this to me, this person betrayed me here, etc., etc. When we place our security within ourselves, we can't let that happen because we're not putting the circumstances outside of ourselves for these things to be happening. So when we're looking at Neptune through the eighth house, what's happening here is that you are psychologically purifying the nature of your psyche, okay? The psychology of yourself, like your inward understanding, how you psychologically understand the nature of humanity. Now, what we're looking at here is where you're learning to purify is understand the nature of your own motivations, your own fears of abandonment and betrayal and loss and mistrusts. Unfortunately, what happens here is that you project this into the reality, thinking that it's the other person that is inherently non-trustworthy, creating the dynamic within you of separation, the illusion of separation, in which the other person is not trustworthy and therefore I shouldn't open up. Why? Because the wounding within yourself is creating the very pain that's allowing this to not happen, but then the projection is within the other person. So what happens is that through a constant series of crises, you'll come to recognize that the person that is actually being reflected through these painful feelings of non-trust and fears and abandonments and what is your motivation, etc., and can I trust you, are recognized that it's the soul itself that has had a series of lifetimes in which this has happened. So the abandonment of God, the abandonment of love. Which is why intimacy can be a very interesting thing when it comes to the 8th house Pluto. And of course, when it comes to marriage and it comes to relationships in itself, it can be difficult because obviously the partner might feel like they're not fully committed to you because you aren't able to commit to yourself, but you would always project into the reality that is inherently them. Obviously, because this has happened to you in the past. Now, what I want you to know is that what happens here is that there's a natural connection between the Neptune of unification and healing, where you learn to apply compassion and empathy and compromise and understanding within yourself, and you learn to extend the sense of trust that you have to another person, even though it creates a sense of fear, allowing yourself to be understood, that the security comes from within, that no matter what happens, you will always be safe in that experience. Because inherently within your consciousness, there's this feeling of the rug being pulled under your feet, and so therefore the reality comes here, and you have this psychic trauma where you have just seen this abandonment betrayal happen. Now, one of the most beautiful things that actually happens through this experience is once you've able to actually heal through this, you will naturally be gravitating towards extreme deep spiritual practices of true sexuality, true commitment, true merging with another person. Tantra, for instance, is a great example of what you will be attracted to, naturally seeking the taboo within the sexual realm and the sexual energy, and definitely expanding this nature of your consciousness to a point where the understanding of sexuality is not just the physical attraction, but there is the deep essence of what exists beneath the surface here. So these are wonderful traits that exist over there, but remember about the nature of healing the psychology through recognizing all these fears and motivations and abandonment and betrayals, okay? Fantastic. Well, I really hope that that helped you in that sense and gave you this understanding, okay? Be sure to come over to my website, simonforster.com, and also like, share, and subscribe to this video, and if it's helped you, obviously pass it on. I do write for Wake Up World, write for myself through Wake Up World as well. Lots of articles about the new moons and such. So if you're interested in the work that I've been doing, check out that. The link will be in the description below, okay? And also the Facebook page, which I have as well, and all the links are in the description. Fantastic. Okay, guys. Well, I really hope that you enjoyed this. I hope it gave you some clarity. And until then, have a fantastic evening. Take care. Bye-bye.